Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. In Jesus, you are known by the quality of knowledge, not by this turban and beard or anything like that. It has nothing to do with the religion. So, I have rendered exposition of the gospel. The meanings are hidden under the parables. And those who have discerning intellect or Holy Spirit, which is common sense, they will get the gospel. Others will just read the dead letters on the top and argue with each other. That is called dead burying their dead, as you see them in the universities. So they hardly have any knowledge why Jesus is called Yeshua. They have no understanding what it means. It doesn't mean Savior, because they have written in the Bible with Savior, you know, it's wrong. Yeshua is from Yah. From Yahweh, Shua means Adam, the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was sired by Yahweh. John the Baptist baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh, and Jewish men in the name of Abraham. Nowhere in the name of Father, Son, or Holy Spirit or anything. This nonsense was brought by the Messianic Jews when they occupied the church. They corrupted the whole thing. That is, the light came among his own and they loved darkness. There it is amply reflected in John 7, verse 1 to 13. Holy Gospel of Jesus, the Christ, the anointed Christ, it should be rather. Christ is the title. After this, Jesus went about in Galilee. Now, Galilee was the area which was the Jewish people said, hey, they are far away from Jerusalem and far away from Judea region. So they don't have much knowledge, religious knowledge. People of the Judah tribe, they were number one in the religious knowledge, book knowledge that was left, but not spiritual. So they said, hey, this people from Galilee, they haven't read any books. They are not well versed in Torahs, this and that, as we in Judea region are. So they are stupid people. So that's why Jesus went about in Galilee, away from the Judea region, because they hated him. He did not wish to go about in Judea because the Jews were looking for an opportunity to kill him. So you can see how much they were hating him. Remember when Lazarus died and Jesus wanted to go back to Judea region, and his friends, brethren, not disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. And you discipline natural men, not the twice born, sensible people. So the Messianic Jews, they corrupted this one. So the Jews were looking for an opportunity to kill him because he was having superiority over the others. He came from our supernatural father, so he had the supernatural powers. Where the people of the Judea region, they even hated their own demiurge god Yahweh by becoming Jew outwardly. When you become Jew outwardly, you replace your tribal self with Jew. When you replace the tribal self with Jew, and then you become tribeless person. A person born of the prostitute has no tribe. because we don't know who fathered him, you know. But the Jews, they know they are of Judah tribe, but when they become Jew outwardly, they throw away Judah tribe. And they say, hey, we are Jew. That means they become super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44. That is what Jesus said. Not just devils, but super bastard fanatic devils. Saltless people. As Jesus did good works, they kill him. So now the Jewish festival of booths was near. So his brothers said to him in Galilee, you know, because the people of the Galilee were taught by the Jewish people as they are stupid people, no knowledge. So his brothers were very proud, you know, that he can perform miracles and all that. That means his village brothers, Galilee brothers, not brother in flesh. He had no brother in flesh. Leave here and go to Judea so that your laborers also may see the works you are doing. So Jesus had laborers, not disciples. Not the blind disciple as the rabbis had. The Messianic Jew added this word, disciple, and also the Lord and all that, you know. So they say to him that so they can see it also, you know, what you are doing. For no one who wants to be widely known acts in secret. That means they thought, you know, that people of Judah tribe, Judea region, they are well educated, they are well known in spiritual knowledge. When he goes there, then his fame will come up. So that's what they say. Nobody is widely known, acts in secret, that you have to show them everything. But they are jealous of him, you know, that he can do this thing, that thing. They can't do it because they were useless. No knowledge of oral Torah, no his word, and no miracles or anything they could do. If you do these things, show yourself to the world, because many people come to Jerusalem. Jerusalem used to be the temple in the Middle East, well known for worship. As in India, we have Banaras, Hindu temples over there in Banaras. And so was this Jerusalem, the Banaras of the Middle East. For not even his brothers believed in him. So, you know, as you said there, Jesus said, you know, a prophet is not appreciated by his own people. But he was more than a prophet. He was son of the Most High. Sons are greater than prophet. John the Baptist was the last prophet on earth. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. John 16 verse 16. Jesus said to them, my time has not yet come. That means his time to give his sacrifice as Lamb of the God hasn't come yet. But your time is always here. He said to them, your time is always here because you are afraid to preach gospel and to challenge them. The world cannot hate you, but it hates me because I testify against it that it is works, that its works are evil. Now he was, you know, outspokenly were telling people that those things they are doing is wrong. And when they become Jew outwardly, they become super bastards. So such a hard truth, you know, nobody could speak. And Jesus spoke it right in the middle of the temple. They took stones to hit him, but they could not because his time has not come. So, go to the festival yourself. I'm not going to this festival, for my time has not yet fully come. After saying this, he remained in Galilee. But after his brothers had gone to the festival, then he also went, not publicly, but as it were in secret. So he let them go, you know, because they go in groups. Hey, this group come from Galilee, this group come from this side, that side, you know. So he went of his own, solitary, because he was not joined together, he was solitary. And Jesus, we need to be solitary. The Jews were looking for him at the festival. So the Jews, you know, they knew he will come and they're looking for him so they can show their hatred to him and saying, where is he? So they were looking for him. After there was considerable complaining about him among the crowds, the crowds wanted it, you know, to see him. Where is Jesus, our friend? We can't see him. So they were looking for him to have some gospel from him. But the temple priest, they hated him. They wanted to find an opportunity to kill him. While some were saying, he is a good man. So those people in the crowd, they were saying he is a good man. Others were saying, no, he is deceiving the crowd, that he is a magician, he is deceiving the crowd, that means he is not coming to show himself up. A bad man doesn't come, you know. So that's what they were saying. Yet no one would speak openly about him for fear of the Jews. That's the most important. Today, not a single politician or these dog-collar people can speak gospel that hurts Jews. For example, during the Holocaust, not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. Because Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. The Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Outwardly, they are tribal people, Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, and they were born, they died during the Holocaust. Not a single Jew died. Same in India, 1984 and 1947, partition of India. Not a single Sikh, Hindu or Muslim died because they are spiritual self inwardly, not outwardly. Tribal people died. My father knew this subject, and when 2,000 people of neighboring Mohammedan village came to attack us because we were Sikhs, you know, under their terms. But before they wanted to attack our village, they sent a man to our village, go and call the headman. And my father went with him. His elder brother was headman. So when they go to the attacking party headman, and they talk to him that a Muslim and a Sikh, they are spiritual self inwardly, not physical self. Physical self, we are of Jat tribe and you are of Rai tribe. These selves are going to kill, fight and kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, because they are spiritual self, they can't, they have no hands. Sikh is known what comes out of his mouth. Sikh means a student. Student is known by quality, is not quantity. So the headman understood it, and he told the 2,000 people who came to attack us to look after us like their guest. Now this situation, you know, when people are mad, and you can see them in Middle East, how they take the Christians, so-called Christians out, and kill them. That same worse than that was fanaticism was in India, Pakistan. They were killing children, old people, everything, you know. And that's going to happen again. Because this thing is moving against sectarian rights. It is really much stronger. Who will survive? Who will hold on to his tribal identity? That is why in the Revelation 144,000, there are mentioned who will survive the Holocaust and tribulations. They are all tribal people. Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, Judah tribe, but not Jew or Hindu or Sikh or Muslim. They will all die, fanatic. And such people are found, tribal people are found in Africa jungle, African jungle, and also in Brazilian jungle. And they will start the new generation again. White and black people. Then you have Semitic race, mix of the two. Abraham was a Semitic race. He was not a Jew. And for his quality, because he was a righteous person, he was a Muslim, not a Mohammedan. Mohammedan is a follower of Muhammad. What Muhammad told them, they did it. The Islam, real Islam of Inshallah, Allah is sun, primary source of light, not moon and star. Allah is Noor, light. You can't see it. You can't feel it. So, Inshallah, to go by His will. Nobody can stand between man and Allah. That is Inshallah. If this mullah come between man and Allah, mullah comes between moon and star, then he implies his own sharia or fatwas, inshmullah. That Islam is of inshmullah and it is of Satan. Second coming of Jesus, Nanak proclaimed him to be a Satan because they were doing wrong thing. So real mullah or real rabbi or a Brahman is one who has love of God in his heart. No love of Allah, no love of humanity. Most of these Mohammedans, they don't know why Allah is called Allah. The word Allah is from Illah. Illah is the tribal father. They used to be 100 and or 300 over Illah, tribal gods at Kaaba. Kaaba is the temple of Adam. Nothing to do with God. Nothing to do with Allah. Temple of God. And over there, they were worshipped. Each tribe had its own tribal god, which is called Illah. And they used to keep Kaaba to their right-hand side while going around. This is called Ba'illah. Today, they go and do it on the left-hand side. Left-hand means we have deserted you, passed you. And there used to be only for boys, 12 to 16. Now you see the women, all these children, everything old and young, they are going there like mad people. And the circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only, and his seed. These people from India, European, who have got circumcision, ask them, are they of the seed of Isaac? Are they of Semitic race? We are having this one? No, that is the madness. And those people will kill these Jews today. Because Angel Stephen, when he was called to temple, he told them, our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Be noble and don't make fake sons of Abraham. And they said they were making business out of it. Ritual, putting a millstone and catching prey. So they told their stooge, go and take him out and kill him. They killed him by stoning. Today they are getting bundled up around Israel to kill them. So you can't blame a third person. It is their own creation. Fake sons of Abraham through circumcision, which we call super bastard fanatic devils. And you will see how they kill and burn each other. Our Father God blesses you.